love being at Mount Hermon. There's just something magical about this place. So just being here with family and familiar faces that we see every year. And
we're having food together, we're walking together, we're praying together. All that stuff has been really nice, because normally throughout the year, we don't have that time. We don't have that ability to just kind of pause and just enjoy each other like this. Last year, it was a hard year, right? So it was a challenging year. I didn't know what the future was going to look like, and it was a really scary time.
For me, it was really hard not coming here last year because it's been a tradition ever since I was like 3 years old. I've gotten closer to each person every year because for the most part, a lot of the same people come to week one.
It's been great because it's a break from what has been reality, so it feels a little bit more like normal. Things here have been very normal for the most part, so it's been great to feel like it was pre-pandemic. So
it's been hard for a lot of people this last year, so getting to come to camp, you get to have fun again and be together with family, and we have other family members here and friends, and so you get to see everybody and just get back to the way it used to be, which has been really fun.
Here's the idea. Life does not exist without giving and serving. There's no self-centeredness in the context of the Trinity, which means when you and I are selfish and we're self-centered, we are bumping up against ultimate reality. This is why self-centeredness and selfishness destroys the human soul. This is why Jesus said, to find your life, you must lose it.
One of the things that's really stood out to me is how selfish I am. I mean, it's really hard to see that. But when you look against God's word, it's really pretty obvious. That's something I absolutely am going to be working on.
We just take a break from our normal lives and we can just focus on God and really dive into the Word.
To me, it's just a place to like get away, to escape from, you know, the busyness of life and technology in a way, because, you know, it makes you get away and just spend time as a family and have lots of fun. So Everywhere you look, you can't help but see God. So it's a good reminder of that. So I love it.
bottom line is this: you're already loved. You're already chosen. And so out of that knowledge, that's when we get to act. We're not trying to earn. We're not trying to prove anything. We already got everything we need, everything we want in Jesus. And because of that, we have his power then through the power of the Holy Spirit to live the way he wants us to live, which isn't easy, which is why we need his power. But we simply ask, God, help me.